Hey guys, I want to say thank you for watching my video. This is something that I really didn't think I would see. Democrats should ask Clinton to step aside by the Chicago Tribune. You know, the way the media has deified Clinton, I just really never thought I would see a paper actually call for her to step aside, or that the Democrats should say that they need to pick her vice president to replace her. As you can see, this is quite a long article. I'll leave the link in the description. You can come here and read it. But this is what I like right here. It says, if ruling Democrats hold themselves to the high moral standards they impose on the people they govern, they would follow a simple process. They would demand that Mrs. Clinton step down immediately and let her vice presidential nominee, Senator Tim Kaine of Virginia, stand in her place. Now, I'm no fan of Tim Kaine. I don't think he's much better than Clinton, but at least he's not being investigated by the FBI twice in the same presidential election year, and just a few days, 8, 9 days before the election, a second FBI probe has been opened up. Now, I'll leave the link to this page too. This is actually from the United States Government Publishing Office. This is why I believe that Hillary Clinton should never have been allowed to run for any form of public office, period. It's U.S. Code Title 18, Section 2071. Whoever willfully and unlawfully conceals, removes, mutilates, obliterates, or destroys, or attempts to do so, or with intent to do so, takes and carries away any record, proceeding, map, book, paper, document, or other thing filed or deposited with any clerk or officer of any court of the United States or in any public office, or with any judicial or public officer of the United States, shall be fined under this title or imprisoned not more than 3 years, or both. Whoever, having the custody of such record, proceeding, map, book, document, paper, or other thing, willfully and unlawfully conceals, removes, mutilates, obliterates, falsifies, or destroys the same, shall be fined under this title or imprisoned not more than 3 years, or both, and shall forfeit his office and be disqualified from holding any office under the United States. That right there should disqualify this woman from running. On November 8th, we need to vote. We need to be silent no more. We need to have our voices heard. We need to remind people of those that have lost their lives, such as in Benghazi, where she decided to go back to bed when the ambassador was being murdered and then blame it on a video. We need to remind people how callous she is when she laughed about getting someone that she knew was guilty off of the charge of rape on a 12-year-old. We need to remind people how she steals, when she stole things out of the mansion in the governor's office when they left, how she stole things out of the White House when they left. Did we really get everything back? Come on. The only thing that they have to sell is their influence. Do we really want to put this woman in a position where she has that much power and influence? Do we really want to continue being the laughing stock of the world? Vote November 8th. Vote your conscience. I can tell you I'm not going to vote for Hillary Clinton. I want to say thank you for watching my video. God bless.